This is so unimportant in the grand scheme of things, but mystery solved. It was my aunt who lives in Massachusetts. I texted her and I said, did you by any chance send me a book? And she says, yes, but I didn't think it would get there till tomorrow. I was going to tell you about it. And I said, oh, it looks like a good read, very interesting. And she said, yeah, I know you really like her. So I said, oh, well, I don't remember ever mentioning that, but thank you for thinking of me. Were you perhaps thinking of Joni Mitchell? And she said, oh my God, that's who she thought. That's who she thought of. She saw the J and got confused for a moment. She's an older woman. But she thought of me and she sent a thoughtful gift and I thanked her and I told her I would read it, which I will. Pretty thick book. So yeah, it was her and it's nice that she thought of me. And at some point, I mean, I do have some books about Joni Mitchell, but on my wish list for Christmas, which I might drop hints about to a certain person, is a wonderful, huge book of like all of Joni Mitchell's lyrics. She is my favorite. She's like my favorite singer. Along with Eva Cassidy and Jane Monheit and the tragic Karen Carpenter and the miraculous Billie Eilish. I jumped on that bandwagon and I was blown away. So, anyway, I picked up a rotisserie chicken, segueing right into food, of course, stuffing and a vegetable and gravy and dessert for my friend who's here visiting for a couple days. It was his birthday in September, but he had pneumonia, and I wasn't able to see him, if you recall that. That was the day I was going to go to the Ren Fair, and he was too ill to go, and I don't like to go to things like that alone. Wow, there's like a double moon outside. No, it's a moon with a reflection. There's no such thing as a double moon unless you're in Star Wars. So, yeah, I'm going to do a dress barn haul later on. I was so excited to be in there. I don't usually like that store. I have a credit card from there that I'm trying to pay off. But they're going out of business, so they had a crazy good sale. And I went into their plus size section, of course, and also their normal size section because I found a really cute top and a cosmetic bag for my daughter. And I'll show you the tops later on in the boots I got. But for now, I'm going to serve some dinner to my dear friend, Steven, who's right now out rummaging around on my porch looking for the remote to this thing because it's not supposed to flash all different colors like that. It's supposed to have different settings, different colors, and it's kind of weird that it's just blue with like a little patch of the multicolor, but it's not a big deal. It's still pretty. I'm very, very into my little lights and things. And there was something else I was going to say about my busy day, but I'm still feeling good. I'm feeling optimistic. I'm not feeling like Nick and I are going to like, I'm not happy because I think we're going to get back together in a romantic sense, but we framed it in such a way together. He framed it to me and in a very gentle, tender, kind way that it's not like a downshift or a diminishment or a demotion to suddenly be a friend. It's going to be fine and it's going to be better for us. And it takes a lot of stress and pressure off when there's no romantic expectations or sexual expectations or disappointments or demands or jealousy or anxiety, you know, because you don't feel that way with friends, just with lovers. So having said that, he still was very charming last night at dinner and complimentary and gentle. And, you know, we hugged, we held hands. I guess friends can do that or not. So I'm going to go pay attention to my other friend now. Peace. Talk to you later, you guys. So the book Mystery is Solved. My generous aunt sent that to me. And she said, there's no mistakes. Sometimes good things can come from mistakes. And I said, don't I know it? So it's all good. All will be well, which is one of the things Nick always says to me. I still love him. I'm not going to lie. And he says he loves me too. It's just a different kind of love now. Peace.